Hey there, other strangers. We need to catch up. So I've been out for about 2.5 months, and there are some reasons for that, and we'll get into that a little bit later. But you guys asked some questions about my job in the group chat, and I wanted to go ahead and answer those. For those of you who are not from the Strangers group, I am a professional theatrical costumer. I make costumes for theater, essentially, and I do a lot of different things under that umbrella. That means I can help with quick changes backstage. That means I sometimes design shows. Sometimes I'm building. Most of the time I'm building, actually, and that's really what I enjoy doing. So, Jay, you asked, how long have I been doing this, and what is my best costume-related experience? So, I've been sewing since I was 10. I've been doing theater-related things since I was 14 or 15, depending on if you count theater summer camp or performances. theater summer camp I started when I was 14. I had my first performance outside of like those school required plays in elementary school when I was 15. I went to college for musical theater, and I worked in the costume shop all 4 years there, and I went into costuming as soon as I graduated. Said, I like this pay a little bit better. It's a little bit more stable. I think I'm gonna stick with this. It's something I still enjoy, still doing theater, still doing something creative and something I love. What is my best costume related experience? I'm gonna say, like, in the context of my favorite show I've ever done, in terms of dressing a show, like working backstage with quick changes, that has to be The Mystery of Irma Vep, because the actors, there was just two, so we weren't dealing with all kinds of drama, which has happened. But we just had two actors. They were both fantastic at their craft. They were both fantastic to work with, and I would drop everything and work with them in a heartbeat again. It was a fun show that kept me on my feet, and I just enjoyed being backstage with that particular crew. In terms of from a building costume perspective, this might just be because it was the most recent show, but I really enjoyed Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. I'm gonna try to insert some pictures in here, text of what happened if I can't. I'm gonna put some photos of some of the costumes, just because they were so fun and so crazy. Everybody was excited to work on it, from the shop to the actors. I heard from several crew people that the show was worth coming to see just to see the costumes. It was just an all-around fun time. The designer was great to work with, and he's another person I would drop everything to work with again. So I think that's that question answered. Crystal asked, what is my favorite project I've ever worked on? Project can mean a lot of things. Project can mean an entire show. It can mean an individual costume I've worked on. But because I've kind of just answered favorite show, I'm gonna assume favorite costume piece. And that's kind of a tough choice because I've had a lot of big, fun things I've done in my short career. But as of right now, it has to be the last dress that I made in college. It was my final acting performance in a formal setting. It was this beautiful floor-length red gown with black lace trim. It was long-sleeved. It was fitted from the top to my hips, and then it flared out in a little mermaid style. I felt gorgeous every time I put it on. I just loved being a part of that, and that being the last big thing that I did in school. Savannah, what things have I been able to learn about theater and production by being a hand? And I think you're asking, what have I learned from being a stagehand? And the thing is I enjoy dressing to some extent, but I really don't enjoy it as much as I do construction. The important thing I've learned from it, though, is the show doesn't end once I stop working on it in the shop. It does have a run. it does continue on in its own right. So I have to think, while I'm building the show, how are these pieces going to hold up over time? How long is the run? How are they going to be laundered? All that kind of thing. Especially with quick change heavy shows, which we have a couple of this season, it's really allowed me to understand the extent that things need to be rigged, what are different rigging techniques to use in terms of assisting a dresser and an actor in the best way that they can. All that weird, crazy stuff. Yeah, being a dresser is weird. It's a weird job. I get people undressed and dressed very quickly. I have changes that have to happen in under 15-20 seconds in the show that's currently running that I'm a dresser for, so everything had to be very extensively rigged, and it influenced how I designed the show. Fun fact, I also designed the show that I'm dressing because I knew I was going to have to be backstage and I was going to have to live with all the choices that I made as a designer. It impacted how I thought about the design process, if that makes sense. I think that's all the questions you guys had. So I'm gonna talk about where I've been for 2.5 months. Before I started filming, I looked up when my last video was posted. It was May 14th, which was right before the summer season started, and a lot of things came to a head all at once that I was never able to fully recover from. I feel like I'm kind of getting a breather, but I'm not really. So, not long after my last video posted, I had a breakup with a partner I'd been with in some capacity for the past 3 years. And this was somebody I saw a potential future with that apparently didn't feel the same way. That was devastating. And then a week later, I had tech for the show I was dressing and designing. That was very stressful because it was our first major quick change show that I haven't done a show like that in over a year as a dresser. So just dressing a show of that magnitude is already stressful, but then I also had to be in two different headspaces of I'm dressing in a wardrobe supervisor, but also I have to come out here and talk about my designs that I can't watch. It was very frustrating. And then 2 weeks after that show opened, we opened Matilda. If you've ever done theater, you know opening one show and then 2 weeks later opening another show is mildly insane. So we were working on Matilda and Tuna, Red, White, and Tuna, at the same time, and we had a mass of fittings right after Tuna. We actually ended up having 10 fittings in one day, which, if you have never done a fitting before, it's very intellectually intense because you're trying to be that detail person for a solid 30 minutes. It's a process, and it was very overwhelming. And then after Matilda opened, it's the kind of summer it's been, we had our designer come in for Joseph, and he was fantastic and very organized. But the whole build process was very intense because in this about hour and a half long show, most of the ensemble has like 4 or 5 different looks. 4 different looks in an hour and a half. Joseph has 5 looks in an hour and a half, and we had to essentially build 2 of those looks because he has 2 dream coats. It was a process. It was a long process for all of those builds. On top of having to fit all of the ensemble, which is like 20 people all in 4 looks. So it was good that we had a longer process for that, but it was very draining. It was fun, but it was draining. A week before Joseph opened, I was designing our premier Theater for Young Audiences show, Junie B. Jones. Now, this show was so much fun and I enjoyed it, and that cast is doing amazing, but to have Junie B. Jones open and then the next week we open Joseph, I was exhausted. I was done. I was out 2 to 3 days a week dressing a show. I was designing Junie B. Jones and I was assisting with all of the Joseph stuff. I was exhausted. I was coming home and crashing, and my mental health has taken a nosedive. And a nosedive that I haven't seen in myself for a year and a half. I don't have access to therapy or medication like I need. I'm in a very, very small retirement town, and even with financial assistance from BetterHelp, it's more than I can afford right now. I'm doing everything I can to maintain, I guess, but it's not enough, and I know it's not enough, and it's very frustrating that I want to do more for myself, and I just don't have the resources to do more for myself. I try to be very open about my mental health, because if I'm not, I just suffer in silence, and I can't deal with that. It just makes everything worse. Here I am, suffering loudly, I guess. To put into context what's happening, normally I deal with somewhat mild anxiety and depression. To be clear, this is a self-diagnosis, but granted what I know about the two diseases, there's no way that I don't. I've been dealing with not wanting to get out of bed in the morning, with being quick to cry, not being able to sleep through the night, and I woke up the other morning at 4 a.m. and had a panic attack. I don't know what to do. I know I haven't been taking care of myself the way I should, but I also haven't had the energy to do it. But hopefully, I'm gonna get back on track, build back up my habits, get better. And I say this because if I don't, I don't know where I'm gonna be at the end of this season. This summer was crazy, but we open one show late August, one show mid-September, one show mid-October, and two shows in November. Two shows within 2 weeks in November. Our September, October, and first November show are the three biggest shows of the season. And I'm concerned. And I haven't said anything to anyone that I am friends with here yet, so they might see this and be a little taken aback. But I just came to this realization on Saturday myself. Based on what the season's been so far and the fact that it's just gonna get more intense, unless there are some major changes, I have to leave before the end of next season. It's kind of an open secret that I'm not the only one that's leaving at the end of the season. Part of it is not my place to talk about, but because it relates to the business of the theater that I'm at, I'm willing to talk about it in the strangers chat because that's a private chat if y'all want to know. But that's kind of what's been going on with me, strangers. I hope to get back into video making. I miss it. That's all I got for you guys today. DFTBA, other strangers.